Welcome back to my Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness Let's Play. For now, we're going to the Cypher Key Lair. Which, if you've been paying attention, is a shadow Pokemon producing factory. And we're going to run into Zook, the asshole from the beginning of the game. And now that we have our snack machine back, we can finally steal that Zangoose that we've been teased at since the very beginning of the game. So now we're going to take it on Zook. Early enough that Zangoose is actually pretty hard to catch. And so now we've taken down Zook, who is now going to run off and never be seen again because he doesn't want to be yelled at by Master Greevil. Man, it sounds so close to Grievous. It'd be funny if he has. Turns out to be a six-armed robot with lightsabers. Since we're going to heal up fresh, you're going to get a pretty humorous scene with these two giant dudes. Basically, they're going to impede your process of getting in. Telling you that you can't come in here and basically saying if they beat you up, they can get a promotion to admin. And now Gunzap is gonna show up with the sleep powder guy. I don't remember his name. Is it Walken? Oh, Walken! Oh, there's a joke there. If I could do a Christopher Walken impersonation, I'd read his dialogue in that. But I can't, so maybe let's try. So now these two are pretty much going to be out for the entire process of this as we go into the Cypher layer with the obviously polluted lake. This building has a really odd design. It's like a pyramid, but it has a weird building design in it. Anyway, here is the conveyor belt for these two workers. They won't be able to fight them, but they'll talk about how they're impressed with the machinery of a Shadow Pokemon and stuff. And then we'll find a bunch of hyper potions here. And basically it's how they're almost done and how the last Pokemon from the SS Libra has been processed. And that's going to be an important point for later on, which I'll mention. I won't show you, but I'll just mention it. So yeah, yet again, this place is full of ninjas that will jump down from the ceiling to attack you. Yeah, like I said earlier, this place is full of people ready to fight you, so most of this video will be composed of battles, which I've sped up to shorten the runtime, obviously. One other thing about this place is in the last game we got a lot dedicated to processing and making sure Pokemon, but here they've managed to make it an actual industrialized process. Which is kind of interesting. They never really go into the process of how they make Shadow Pokemon. I mean, they really didn't think that part through probably when making a storyline for this stuff. But it's just an interesting little side note to think of. I'm sure it'll take a whole damn lab and now it just takes a few guys with the... If you're noticing how to cut that, I want to go heal. But there's a heal machine there. So yeah, this room is basically what I'm going to call the box room. It's a pretty annoying room that's filled with a bunch of boxes that impede your process. But the room is filled with items, as well as the floor with the healing machine. Did we run to a guy named Grog before? Because I'm pretty sure I think we did. Anyway, his shell Pokemon is a shelter, which we've now got. Yeah, we're basically going to go around exploring this place a bit more as we find this other way into the room of boxes. And again, this entire room is filled with items. Most of them are really helpful recovery items. Just that elixir, that PP up. Well, it's not a recovery item, but still a very helpful little item. And that floor restore there. Okay, so now we've basically looted this floor, let's keep building on. I'm going to hit my Pokemon just for a safe measure. So here's an interesting little room. Oh yeah, before I forget, there's another item to get from this little area. I basically have to go downstairs to get it. Still don't get another rare candy. And Ultra Balls, which will be helpful. Thank you. after healing, okay, back to this room. This is basically a puzzle room. You have to match, have to put the pressure on these weights, so basically you have to move the boxes around. It's a simple puzzle. Not really complicated, just easy. Basically show the layout of the room. You have to get both sun and moon to unlock that door. So now we've put the pressure on, so that door should be open. It's just a little simple puzzle. I think it's just padding, maybe. Anyway, we're gonna, and I'm gonna get jumped by this guy. The lock. That's the most normal name we've run into so far. So if you're noticing now, the Shao Pokemon rate is really going up in these past few videos. I don't know why. But they're using more Shadow Pokemon, which is understandable. Anyway, that's going to be it for this video. Join us next time as we finish off the Cypher facility.